Hi, my name is Scott Mansfield, and I'm an undergraduate student of biomedical engineering. This summer, I participated in the Summer Undergraduate Research and Engineering Program, and I'm going to talk to you about enhancing the immune response to subunit vaccines. During my project, I worked under the mentorship of Dr. James Moon and Dr. Preeti Sadev. A liposome is a small nanoparticle composed of lipids similar to a cell membrane. In water or other aqueous solutions, lipids assemble into a spherical bilayer with their tails facing inward towards each other to avoid contact with water. They are an exciting method of drug delivery because they can encapsulate water-soluble compounds in their core as well as lipid-soluble compounds inside the bilayer. Subunit vaccines contain a single or small number of proteins from a virus or bacteria, but are typically weaker than standard live virus vaccines. A way to enhance their strength is to deliver the protein encapsulated in a special liposome called an ICMV. I will now show you how they are made.
The first step is to take 200 microliters of 10 millimolar bis-tris propane solution and add it to the lipid film contained in this glass vial. This hydrates or dissolves the lipids, allowing them to come together to form liposomes. Then, each vial is vortexed for 10 seconds every 10 minutes for 1 hour to ensure complete hydration of the lipids. The solution in the vial should appear cloudy, indicating the formation of liposomes. Now that the liposomes have been successfully assembled, they must be removed from the vial and placed into a 1.5 milliliter Eppendorf tube. Next, the liposomes must be sonicated on ice for 5 minutes at 40% amplitude, switching from on to off every 30 seconds to prevent overheating. Sonication subjects the liposomes to ultrasonic waves that break the liposomes into smaller particles. After sonication, 4 microliters of 150 millimolar DTT is added to each sample. DTT is a chemical crosslinker that forms a bridge between malamide head groups on opposed bilayers. Next, 40 microliters of 200 millimolar calcium chloride is added. The positive charge of the calcium ions draws the negatively charged phospholipids contained on each bilayer close together. This allows the liposomes to fuse together and create multilamellar liposomes. The solution should become cloudy as soon as the calcium is added. Each sample is then incubated at 37 degrees Celsius for 1 hour to ensure that the fusion and cross-linking of the liposomes is fully carried out.
At this point, the particles have progressed from simple liposomes to multilamellar and cross-linked liposomes. A microscopic view of these ICMVs is shown at the bottom of the screen. After incubation, each sample is centrifuged for 4 minutes at 18,000 G at 4 degrees Celsius. This separates the liposomes from the solution due to their density, and causes them to form the pellet seen at the bottom of the tube. After the initial centrifugation, the remaining solution, called a supernatant, needs to be removed from the pellet. The pellet is then resuspended in 200 microliters of deionized water. The solution should again appear cloudy. The resuspended liposomes are then centrifuged again using the same settings as before. There should again be a visible white pellet at the bottom of each tube. The washing and centrifugation step is repeated a third time. Once this final pellet is obtained, 100 microliters of 10 milligrams per milliliter PEG thiol is added to each sample. PEG, or polyethylene glycol, increases the stability of liposomes and helps protect them from being cleared out of the bloodstream. Upon addition of PEG, the particles should again appear cloudy. Each sample is incubated again for 30 minutes at 37 degrees Celsius. These final ICMV formulations are then washed and centrifuged 2 times as described before. The final pellets are then resuspended in 200 microliters of deionized water and are ready to be used or stored. The use of ICMVs has shown enhanced immune responses when compared with unencapsulated antigen as well as other forms of liposomes. For more information on ICMVs, please read the article shown on the screen. And thank you for watching this video.